Welcome to this brief introduction to confidence intervals. In inferential statistics, we study a sample and use the results to draw conclusions about its population. Suppose I want to estimate the average age of students at a college, so I choose a random sample and find the sample mean age to be 23. This sample mean of 23 is called a point estimate of the population mean mu. So a point estimate is a single value, that is, a statistic computed from sample data and used to estimate a population parameter. Because a point estimate is a single value, we can't really tell how good it represents the population. So in inferential statistics, we prefer to use an interval or a range of values to estimate the population parameter. For example, suppose we found that the mean age of students at the college lies between 21.5 and 24.5. This range of values is an interval estimate, which we refer to as the confidence interval. We refer to the smaller value as the lower confidence limit, LCL, and the higher value as the upper confidence limit, UCL. This interval was actually obtained by taking the sample mean 23 and subtracting and adding 1.5 to it. That is, 23 minus 1.5 gives 21.5, and 23 plus 1.5 gives 24.5. The 1.5 is referred to as the margin of error, or error bound. Different letters like E, B, and M are used to represent it, but let's just use E. In essence, the confidence interval estimate for a population mean lies between the sample mean minus the margin of error and the sample mean plus the margin of error. The margin of error is calculated based on a confidence level. The confidence level basically refers to the percent of confidence intervals from many samples that we expect to contain the true population parameter. Confidence levels of 90%, 95%, and 99% are often used, but 95% is the most commonly used confidence level. To illustrate, suppose the true population mean age at the college is 22.5. If we select 10 samples of the same size and construct 10 confidence intervals at 90% confidence level, we will expect 9 of the 10 to contain the population mean. And with 95%, we will expect 19 out of 20 intervals to contain the population mean. Now, suppose the interval 21.5 to 24.5 was obtained at the 95% confidence level. To interpret that, we say we are 95% confident that the true population mean lies between 21.5 and 24.5. Note that it would be incorrect to say that there is a 95% chance that the population mean lies between 21.5 and 24.5. What the 95% confidence interval means is that if we select 100 samples of the same size, 95 of the confidence interval obtained from them will contain the population mean. This interval from 21.5 to 24.5 here is just one of those 100 intervals. And that concludes this introduction to confidence intervals. Thanks for watching.